Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Theresa May could be given a last chance to sell her Brexit plan directly to EU counterparts amid rising fears about deadlock in negotiations. A summit for leaders is being penciled in for September as efforts are stepped up by both sides to avoid a damaging failure to get a deal. Germany is said to be increasingly alarmed at the intransigence of the European Commission, with Jean-Claude Juncker and Michel Barnier flatly refusing to compromise. Last week, Mr. Barnier effectively took an axe to Mrs. May's Chequers blueprint, which would see the UK effectively stay in the single market for goods and collect some tariffs on behalf of the EU. The gathering, expected to be held in Austria, is being billed as a chance for Mrs. May to go over the heads of the Eurocrats and thrash out a solution with national leaders. However, the French Minister for European Affairs has attempted to kill off the idea that the PM will be allowed to sidestep Mr. Barnier, saying, he is the negotiator for the EU. An EU summit next month is being billed as an opportunity for Theresa May, pictured at the Royal Welsh Show today, to go over the heads of the Eurocrats and thrash out a solution with national leaders. Mrs. May inspected the livestock as she toured the Royal Welsh Show this morning. The potential shift comes as Dominic Raab and Michel Barnier, pictured left and right in Brussels last week, are due to hold more face-to-face talks. Up until now, Mrs. May has only been permitted to address the European Council of Leaders on Brexit, rather than negotiate with them directly. All discussion of Britain's departure between the 27 remaining states has been done, without the PM in the room. But one Berlin source told The Times, there is a sense of drift. It is time for leaders to have a serious discussion in the European Council. Another source added, there is potential to have talks between all 28 EU leaders. The potential shift comes as Dominic Raab and Michel Barnier are due to hold face-to-face talks in Brussels at the end of the latest round of Brexit negotiations. The Brexit secretary has promised to bring as much energy as I can to the talks with the European Union's chief negotiator. But there is a growing pessimism about the prospects for a breakthrough. Both sides have been stepping up plans to cope with a collapse in talks which would result in the UK leaving without a deal in March 2019. What is in Theresa May's Brexit blueprint? These are some of the key features of the Chequers plan being pushed by the UK government: a new free trade area in goods, based on a common rulebook of EU regulations necessary. This will require the UK to commit by treaty to match EU rules, mobility rules, which will end automatic freedom of movement, but still allow UK and EU citizens to travel without visas for tourism and temporary work. It will also enable businesses to move staff between countries. Continued UK participation in and funding of European agencies covering areas like chemicals, aviation safety and medicines. A facilitated customs arrangement, removing the need for customs checks at UK-EU ports. It would allow differing UK and EU tariffs on goods from elsewhere in the world to be paid at the border, removing the need for rebates in the vast majority of cases. In theory, this allows Britain to sign trade deals, keeping services, such as banking illegal support, outside of the common rulebook, meaning the UK is completely free to set its own regulations. It accepts it will mean less trade in services between the UK and EU. Continued cooperation on energy and transport, a common rulebook on state aid and commitments to maintain high standards of environmental and workplace protections. A security deal allowing continued UK participation in Europol and Eurojust, coordination of UK and EU policies on foreign affairs, defence and development. Continued use of the EHIC health insurance card. Mrs. May said yesterday that the British public should take reassurance and comfort from government preparations for a no-deal Brexit after it emerged plans were being developed to stockpile food and medicines. The PM talked up the positives from leaving the EU as she attended the Royal Welsh Show Agricultural Show today. It seems to me that what we have when we come out of the common agricultural policy is an opportunity to determine what is going to be right for the United Kingdom, rather than being part of policy developed for a number of countries within the EU, she told farmers in a speech. So that gives us a real opportunity, I think, for the future and to be able to set this industry on a really bright prospect for the future. But French Minister for European Affairs Nathalie Lisseau insisted Britain would come off worst if there was no deal. She said that while the EU did not want the UK to crash out, it would not accept a bad deal. She told BBC Radio 4's Today, I do remember Prime Minister May saying that no deal was better than a bad deal. It's among the bad solutions, but I should say that no deal is not as bad as a bad deal for the European Union as well. We would all suffer, the worst would be for the United Kingdom, but we get prepared for a no deal because until now we have seen no significant progress regarding the withdrawal agreement which would relieve us from this concern that there could be a no deal exit. Musliso said a no deal Brexit would slow down trade relations between the UK and France, Belgium, the Netherlands and every entry point to the European Union. Asked what it would mean for the port of Calais, she said, on the day of the United Kingdom leaving the European Union with no deal, we should start with new tariffs and controls, and that means of course traffic jams in Calais and in each and every European port welcoming goods and people coming from the United Kingdom. In a worrying sign for Mrs. May, Musliso insisted Mr. Barnier represented the views of the EU as a whole. There should be no mistake. Michel Barnier does not represent only the Commission. He is the negotiator for the European Union, she said. There is no difference between what Michel Barnier says and what we would say individually. Each and every member state, former Waitrose managing director and international trade minister Lord Price warned that a no-deal Brexit would push up the cost of fruit and veg, meat and dairy products because they could not be stockpiled. The UK currently relies on Europe for 80% of vegetables and 30% of fruit, and finding new routes and supplies would push up costs, he warned. What you will see is rather than a pinch on supply, although that is highly likely, is a pretty significant increase in the cost of fruit and veg, the cost of meat and the cost of dairy products, he said. In an interview with Five News yesterday, the Prime Minister did not deny stockpiling is happening, but said the government is being responsible and sensible, while still trying to get a good deal with the European Union. Angela Merkel, pictured with her husband at a Wagner festival this week, is said to have become increasingly concerned at the intransigent stance taken by the EU Commission. Mrs. May said, far from being worried about preparations that we are making, I would say that people should take reassurance and comfort from the fact that the government is saying we are in a negotiation, we are working for a good deal, I believe we can get a good deal, but, because we don't know what the outcome is going to be, let's prepare for every eventuality. The European Commission has told member states and firms operating in the EU to step up their own preparations for a cliff-edge Brexit. The Prime Minister will engage in her own round of Brexit diplomacy tomorrow, travelling to Austria for talks with counterpart Sebastian Kurz and other EU leaders at the Salzburg Festival.